There's been a lot of debate and discussion around DC's plan to open up two new distributors in Lunar and UCB. In this case, Discount Comic Book Service and Midtown are the parent companies or sister brother companies. Who knows? They're attached to those two. And DC reached out to get more distribution at a time when Diamond was looking fairly shaky and was not able to operate. So there, to put it mildly, there was a backlash. A number of retailers expressed a lot of concerns, but not all those concerns were valid. And some tipped really deeply into the, what I would call, crazy town of conspiracy theories. So let's debunk a couple of those and kind of get to what's what. Hey, everybody, this is Perch. A shout out to Sean Gordon Murphy, who actually suggested I go into this a little bit. And it's a good one because, as I've done in other videos, and as I've said, a lot of people in the comic industry, not just retailers, but publishers, creators, everybody, at times are resistant to change. And what's curious about that is if you look over kind of the history of comics, even dating back to things that John Byrne did way back when he was at Marvel, or various things that Mark Grunwald or Jim Shooter or other names, Bob Harris, have done, history tends to benefit and favor bold action and change. Not every idea works out, but there's lots of evidence to suggest that just kind of burying your head in the sand and doing nothing does not work out, whether it was kind of what happened to comics in the 70s with DC or in the 90s with Marvel, or even today. There's, it doesn't pay to do nothing. And the same thing can be said of retailers, although retailers are sitting in an interesting little bubble, because if you happen to get a shop and you put it in a certain location, you acclimate your lifestyle to, not necessarily needing to make a lot of revenue, you can get to this place where you're not really successful, but you're also not being shut down either. So to you, that just is normal. And you start to defend the status quo. You start to defend not changing, even though your current situation is not good. And that's a weird place to be if you think about it. It's almost like a Stockholm syndrome. Something is wrong, but you fear that change will make it worse more than improving your situation. So you just kind of hunker down and live with where you're at. But DC, facing kind of this crisis where Diamond is not able to produce comics, can't be open, and for many, many years, lots of people, nearly everyone, including retailers who are now complaining, would say, we've got single source distribution, we've got a chokehold, we've got a monopoly, we've got Diamond. Whether they liked or hated Diamond, everybody identified this as a risk, that if you had just one company as the, with their finger on the dike, that would be extremely dangerous for comics. And sure enough, COVID comes out and it plays out as a problem. So DC moves into action relatively quickly, maybe too quickly, because some of the details were not ironed out and needed to be. But regardless of all that, DC pushes to basically get these two new distributors set up. And the reaction was steeply divided. Some comic shops were for it. Some comic shops are very hostily against it, and thus then the conspiracy theories start really rolling out. Now, facts are facts. A couple things that are truthful that have nothing to do with conspiracy theories or anything else is number one, this all moved very, very quickly. Number two, a lot of the information, some of the details had not been worked out, and the communication plan was not the best. It wasn't that it was wrong. It just several pretty important details that should have been released were not, because they weren't known yet. And an ideal situation would have been better to wait until all the T's and C's were marked up. And then the initial ordering through this did not go as planned. Now, credit where credit's due. A little bit of the blame here is around the misinformation that went out. In particular, Bleeding Cool published a number of articles, and they have a lot of retailers that read Bleeding Cool, that were wrong. that talked about, you know, regional differences, that talked about how DC was dropping Diamond entirely. That wasn't true, and it never was true. And it forced DC to have to scramble a little bit and put out some press and some retractions. But the damage was done. It did harm the new efforts. It got people confused, and they missed ordering windows and other things. And so I'm not putting all the blame here on Bleeding Cool, but there's been a couple of these sites, Bleeding Cool probably the biggest among them, that lied about, or maybe they didn't understand. But the problem is, when you're in journalism and you're reporting the news, you kind of need to understand. You don't get the excuse of, well, I wasn't very clear, but I went ahead and wrote a story and put things out and wound up distributing false information. False information, by the way, that has not been ever updated or retracted. You can go to the original articles, you can search for them on Google, and you can still see Bleeding Cool talking about how DC dropped Diamond, which was patently untrue. Never any truth to that. But you know, it's kind of the TMZ approach. It's like, well, we heard a rumor, so we ran with it. But even TMZ has a little bit more, you know, ethics in terms of correcting when they're clearly saying something that is proven to be wrong. But regardless, I think the other thing that's true is the ordering system. If you were ordering through Lunar in particular, you had a really bumpy road. Things didn't work very well. Now, by the way, that was part of the whole plan. It's why DC slow rolled these comics coming out, was so these new distributors could, in theory, you know, get things working out. I still think it is impressive, even though there were problems, that they were able to get something set up, going and moving within 8 weeks. That is a that's an accomplishment. And if you think that, you know, Diamond had, you know, decades to get to where they are now, and you know, there's still problems. The idea that these groups, you know, it's to be commended that people move quickly, even if things were not perfect, and they were not, to be clear. But the conspiracy theories that had come out really all center around kind of one thing. Two things. One of it was this misinformation that I already talked about. The second, though, was this idea that Midtown and Discount Comic Book Service were now, you know, competitors, and thus you were letting kind of the fox in the hen house. If you ran your comic shop in, you know, Topeka, and then you suddenly you're working through Midtown, you're now giving order numbers and you're giving information to a in theory competitor. Now, there is one aspect of this that I think is truthful, and that's anytime you're disclosing financial information, you're doing ordering information to someone else, you need to make sure that information stays confidential. This was brought to sharp focus about a year ago when Diamond messed up and leaked order numbers out to a bunch of retailers. That happened. That was not Midtown. That was not Discount Comic Book Service. That was Diamond who did that. And it was bad. A bunch of retailers got their information, you know, stuff went out public that shouldn't have been, and a bunch of articles were written, and it was not a good situation. The fear here is that a comic shop in Topeka will, you know, suddenly order things through Midtown. Midtown will take a look at that and go, aha, now I see what that store in Topeka is doing. Now I can, I don't know. That's the problem with conspiracy theory is it's not good for confidential information to get out places, but what would they do with that confidential information if they have it? So, I mean, again, and what I've heard from other retailers is, well, now, you know, Midtown's going to know how many comics I order. It's not certain that they do, and one would hope for legal reasons that whatever agreement DC has structured with Midtown and others, they will keep these books separate, that they will not, you know, part of setting up a sister company means that they are going to have, you know, lines of ethical rules between the two, that these things won't just shuffle over. But let's say it didn't occur. Let's say you're ordering, you've got your store in Kansas and you're ordering your stuff through Midtown, and Midtown sees your numbers. What's the consequence there? That Midtown's going to go, oh my God, I didn't realize that Kansas is, you know, selling this massive amount of comics. Look, quick, let's open up a Midtown Kansas. Is that the worry? What exactly are we worried about here? I think if you want to be successful in implementing change, you've got to at least have some idea of what the problem is. And the problem in this case simply seems to be, I don't want to share my books. And again, you shouldn't have to. These things should be kept separate. But there's no evidence right now that they're not. Again, Bleeding Cool stirred the pot a little bit by making it sound like, oh, did you realize these companies are secretly registered to Midtown? An hour later, DC and it published, you know, the math. They basically said, here's who's behind it. Here's what we're doing. Here's everything about it. They just put it out there. Bleeding Cool kind of stirred it up into a big, like some shenanigans were being pulled there. But, you know, that clearly wasn't the case. Other things that have been said is that if you sign up with Lunar, that they're going to make you sign an agreement that you have no recourse if the comics are delivered to you destroyed. That's not true. There's nothing, no truth to that anywhere at all in anything. There's a rumor that there was a loyalty test that if you sign up with UCB, that you basically could never order comics. You had a 2-year window where if you decided to stop doing business, you were not legally authorized to order comics from someone else, that you had to let 2 years, kind of a non-compete, if you will. That's not true. It is not true, nor would be enforceable by any stretch of the imagination. There was a comment that basically by doing this, Midtown and Discount Comic Book Service would get deeper discounts by everyone that they brought on. So if they brought on other retailers, then they would receive a discount for themselves that they would not then pass on to the retailers. I haven't seen those contracts. That's very unlikely to be true as well. That would definitely kick off various legal problems. Some of the retailers have brought up, yeah, they're cheating and they're going to break the law because they know the small comic shops can't afford a lawyer. So therefore they're going to just cheat. That's an interesting, you know, fatalist kind of viewpoint. Once again, there's no evidence this is true. Filing a formal complaint of this type would not require a lot of money or maybe any money from a local comic shop. If you're actually going to sue them personally, I guess, sure. But filing a business ethics complaint is not going to cost you any money to do that. You could just tip people off, and the kind of things people were talking about would definitely do it. The craziest conspiracy theory I heard in all this was that this was basically an approach where they were going to get all the small comic shops to flip over, use it to strong arm Diamond to stop carrying Marvel. Not quite sure how that would work. And then ultimately cut off all the small retail shops as well, leaving Midtown and Discount Comic Book Service as the only comic shops in the country. That plan is weird. And again, makes no sense. So that's the thing with a lot of these conspiracy theories that come out, and a lot of retailers who are happily spreading them around, is one, understand where your information is coming from. In this case, the source of origin was Bleeding Cool, who was posting extremely irresponsible lies out in their articles that were not true and immediately debunked, as in debunked within minutes with formal statements. And Bleeding Cool knew this as well. There's a decent chance that they had some of these answers before they decided to publish their articles. Who knows? Speculation on my part. But as well, understand what you're worried about. What's the threat we're fighting? Is the threat that Midtown's going to compete with you in Kansas? Is that the threat? That's a weird threat. And honestly, you've got a lot of other things to worry about, quite frankly. So anyway, ask, you know, have you heard any of these? Would you like me to clear up any other kind of conspiracy theories you might have heard on this whole topic? Leave me a comment below. I'm happy to go into it, try and explain. Again, my goal here is not to bash other retailers or anyone else. It's just to try and set the record straight on some things. I hate misinformation. It just drives me nuts. So leave a comment below. Like, subscribe if you don't mind. Introduce to a friend. Share a link. Hey, get this stuff out there. I try and do my best. When I'm wrong, I'll admit it. Follow me on Twitter @ComicPerch, and thanks for listening.